On today's episode, computational lithography to enable faster AI development. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. Artificial intelligence is on everyone's mind today. With lightning-fast advances in the capability of AI platforms like ChatGPT, the number of potential use cases for the technology is also growing exponentially, including in engineering. Morgan Stanley analyst Joseph Moore, commenting on recent developments at AI chipmaker Nvidia, described artificial intelligence as one of the most significant developments in technology since the development of mobile internet. Now, at the recent Nvidia Developer Conference, the company made several announcements directly related to engineering, notably in the automotive space and in semiconductor manufacturing. Announcements included BMW's selection of Nvidia to create the automaker's first entirely virtual factory. Omniverse is a platform as a product offering that's notable for the replacement of conventional file formats with universal scene description, an open standard for composing and simulating in 3D. The development is significant because USD was not developed for digital twin applications, but may offer photorealism and interactivity during the design phase for complex production processes or factory layouts. Invented by Pixar Animation Studio, USD is widely believed to be the future global standard for development in the metaverse. On the hardware side, the company announced a new development in computational photolithography using Nvidia software integrated by chip major TSMC and design automation firm Synopsys. But significantly, equipment maker ASML will use the lithography systems and also work with Nvidia on graphics processor units, allowing higher component density and faster production. Nvidia predicts 40 times better performance compared to current lithography, enabling 500 Nvidia DGX H100 systems to achieve the work of 40,000 CPU systems running computational lithography processes in parallel. Gate dimensions on the single-digit nanometer scale were once thought to be impossible, but 7-nanometer technology is now a reality. And according to Nvidia, the combination of XML, Synopsys, and TSMC will allow 2-nanometer scale, again pushing the limits of physics. And that task is complex. A separate photo mask for each of up to 100 layers must be generated, and the masks themselves are not simple negatives, but must incorporate optical correction to address distortion, making the masks themselves a serious engineering challenge beyond a simple negative of the layer pattern. Speed in lithography is essential, as larger die sizes translate to fewer devices per crystal wafer, resulting in lower overall component yields. Chiplet architecture implemented by several of the majors combines multiple smaller dies into one package, but the need to train AI systems is exploding just as the task of manufacturing the high-performance processors needed is becoming more difficult. The open question is whether the computational intensity of AI workloads will favor developers with access to quantum computers, or if a new generation of conventional integrated circuits with higher densities will allow faster, cheaper AI applications in advanced high-value sectors, such as scientific research, medicine, and critically, the replacement of human beings in customer-facing roles, such as sales, customer service, and human resources. And in time, perhaps AI will develop the production technologies necessary to produce the chipsets needed for more advanced AI. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, Designing the Future, and the Engineering Roundtable, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.